गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी पोलिनेशन एंड फर्टिलाइजेशन। एज यू नो स्टूडेंट्स, यू हैव स्टडीड इन चैप्टर 3 द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ फ्लावर, इन विच यू हैव स्टडीड द डिफरेंट पार्ट्स ऑफ द फ्लावर, द रिप्रोडक्टिव पार्ट एंड द नॉन एसेंशियल पार्ट्स विच हेल्प देम इन द पोलिनेशन प्रोसेस। सो नाउ हियर इन द प्लांट दैट रिप्रोडक्शन, द काइंड ऑफ रिप्रोडक्शन दैट इज सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, we are going to study the next that part, that is pollination and fertilization. So let we see what are the topics we are going to study here, that is difference between the self and cross pollination, advantages and disadvantages of self and cross pollination, how nature favors the cross pollination, characteristics of flowers pollinated by insects, wind and water, that is the different type of cross pollination, and the fertilization process, the main events including the double fertilization and triple fusion, and the last topic is the fruit and seed and its definition and the significance. So today in the first that part of this chapter we are going to study about what is pollination, types of pollination and advantages and disadvantages of the pollination. So what is pollination? You have studied in the previous class also that the pollination is the transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma. As you know children, you have studied that anther are actually the part of the male reproductive system here, in which the pollen grains are produced. Pollen grains are the male gametes. So these pollen grains which contains the male gametes in them, they are transferred to the stigma of the flower. So this transfer of pollen grain from the anther to the stigma, this is known as the pollination, and stigma is the part of the female reproductive part, that is the carpel. So this is the pollination. Now this transfer of pollen grains from anther to stigma, it can happen in many ways. Like it may happen that the pollen may be transferred from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, as you can see in this diagram. So in this case, this is known as the self pollination. It may happen that the pollen of the anther here, they may be transferred to the stigma of the another flower, but onto the same plant. Then in that case also, this is a self pollination, but the conditions are different, that I will explain you in the next part. Or it may happen that the pollen grains may fall onto the stigma of another plant of the same species. So on that basis, that pollination is of two types. But one point you must remember, that the pollination occurs between the plant of the same species. So there are the different ways in which the pollen grain can be transferred. So there are two types of pollination, self pollination and cross pollination. Here in this diagram I showed you, this is the self pollination, where the pollen grains are transferred from the anther to the stigma of the same flower itself, and this is the phenomenon known as the autogamy also. So what is the self pollination? The transfer of pollen grains from the anther to the stigma of the same flower, this is autogamy. So this is known as the autogamy also. Or it may happen that pollen grains from the anther, they may be transferred to the stigma of the another flower of the same plant, and this phenomenon is known as the geitonogamy. So geitonogamy and autogamy, these are the two ways which are taking place in the self pollination. So understood children, what is self pollination? And self pollination generally takes place in the bisexual flowers. Why? Because they have both male and female gametes in the same flower. But not always it happen. We will see it in the other cases where the bisexual flowers, they show cross pollination also. It may also occur between the unisexual flowers of the same plant, because you have studied bisexual flower and unisexual flowers. Bisexual, in which both the whorls, that is the reproductive whorls, male and female, are present. In unisexual flower, either of the reproductive whorl is present. So it may occur between the unisexual flower but on the same plant, and it usually takes place in the bisexual flowers. So as the genetic constitution of the gamete is identical, because the gametes are produced in the flower on a same plant or in the same flower, so the genetic constitution is identical, similar. So what happens in this case, that the new plantlets or new plants which are produced after this, they resemble the parent plant. So now we will study the advantages of the self-pollination. What are the advantages of the self-pollination? Self-pollination is easy and most likely to occur. Why it is so? Because stamens and the carpels, the stamens are the male part and carpels are the female part. They both mature at the same time. So it is easy and most likely to occur. Then it preserves the parental characters indefinitely. That same point just now I explained you, that the gametes of the same flower, they fuse, or the flowers of the same plant. So in that case, what happened? The genetic constitution of these gametes is similar. So in that case, the parental characters are preserved. So same characters are only transmitted to the offspring. So in that case, they preserve the parental characters. Now the small quantity of pollen is also sufficient, because what happened? Pollen grains, they do not need to travel a long distance. So in that case, a small quantity of pollens are sufficient in order to pollinate the flower. So in this case, we can say that flower, this method is known as the economical method. Means plant does not need to expend more energy here. The flowers need not to produce nectar and scent, and they need not to be showy, because these all things that showy, scented petals and nectar, they are required to attract the other pollinating agents, but as such there is no need. And the flowers generally do not depend on the pollinating agents, because it is the self-pollination. So understood, children? So these are the advantages of the self-pollination. Now what are the disadvantages of the self-pollination? As self-pollination occurs regularly, generation after generation, so it leads to the loss of vigor and vitality. Vigor means the strength, vitality, that is the life or liveliness. So will be the plant will not have much strength and less energetic. So the plant variety which will be produced continuously by the self-pollination, then it will not have much vigor and vitality. And repeated self-pollination produces poor quality of seeds and produces weak offsprings also. Why it is so? Because there is no variation. The same kind of the genes are transferred from parent to the offsprings. And it may happen that if suppose some genetic defects are there, then these genetic defects are also will be transferred as it is in the offsprings. So the genetic defects of the plant variety cannot be eliminated by this. Then new varieties cannot be obtained. Yes, because there is no intermixing of the genetic constitution of different plant varieties, because flowers are on the same plant and gametes are produced in the same flower. So they have the similar genetic constitution. So after fertilization as such, no new that feature or the character is added. So no new varieties can be obtained by this method. So understood, children? These are the disadvantages of the self-pollination. Now we are going to study the cross-pollination. Another type of pollination is the cross-pollination. What is cross-pollination? That is the transfer of pollen grains from anther of a flower of one plant to the stigma of a flower of another plant, but it is of same species. As I said you earlier also, that pollination occurs between the plant of same species. So here you will see here that the transfer of pollen grains from the anther of a flower of one plant to the stigma of a flower on the another plant. So in this case, what happens? The flowers are located on two different plants. These are two different plants on which these flowers are located. So here the transfer of pollen grains from a flower of a plant to the flower of another plant. So this is known as the cross-pollination. Now in this case, definitely some agency is required to transfer the pollen grains. And this type of pollination is known as the cross pollination, and we call it as allogamy also, allogamy. So this is known as the allogamy also. Cross pollination occurs in unisexual as well as in the bisexual flowers also. So it involves the two separate plants of the same species and the pollinating agents also. You can see here that insect is shown. This insect is carrying the pollen on its body, and when it sits on the another flower there, then the pollen grains which are stick to its body feathers or the body parts, they are actually deposited onto the stigma. So the pollinator, this is known as the pollinator. So this pollinator is actually here the agency which is transferring pollen grains from one flower to another flower. So this is the pollinating agents. Now what are the advantages of the cross pollination? Here the seeds, they are produced, they contain another source of genetic material. As I explained you already that in the self pollination, flower is on the same plant, so the gametes which are produced, they have the same genetic constitution. But in cross pollination, what happens, flowers are located on the two different plants. So in that case, what happens, both the plants, they have the different genetic constitution, the different genes. So in that case, they provide the another source of genetic variation. So it contains the gene which are advantageous for the survival of the seedling, and the seeds which are produced by the cross pollination, they are viable in the healthier one and have the better germinating capacity, and they produce the healthier offsprings also. As the seeds which are produced by the cross pollination, they are viable, able to survive, healthier, they are a strong one, so they produce the healthier offsprings. As well as cross pollination is a source of variation. Yes, source of variation. Why? Because the intermixing of the genes of the two plants. Because why it is intermixing of the genetic makeup or the genes, it is there because flowers are located on two different plants, and both the plants, they have the different genetic constitution. And when the gametes of these two different plants which are produced in these two flowers, they fuse, fertilize, then the seed or which is produced, that will have the features or the characters of both the plants. In that manner, the offspring which will be produced, which will not be exactly similar to these two plants, but it will be having the mixed characters of these plants. So it will provide a source of variation. So these are the advantages of cross pollination. Now we are going to study the disadvantages. What are the disadvantages? Pollination is uncertain because plants have to depend on the external agents for the pollination. Yes, if pollinating agents will not be there or external agents will not be there, then the cross pollination is not possible, and which may or may not be available at the right time. Suppose the pollen grains, they mature, but the pollinating agents are not available. In that case, this pollen grains will not be transferred, so pollination cannot occur. Now the pollen grains have to be produced in the larger amounts. Yes, reason is there because the pollen grains are carried by the pollinating agents, and there are chances of the wastage of the pollen on its way. So a lot of pollen is wasted in this way. Thus the process is not economical. Yes, the why? Because large number of pollen grains have to be produced, as well as the process is not economical because the flowers have to adapt themselves to attract the pollinating agents. So there are some features which develop in the flowers to attract the pollinating agents. For example, flowers should be large in size, showy, colorful petals, scented petals, means scented petals means fragrance should be there, and they should produce the nectar. So the flowers, they have to be large, showy, colorful, scented, and produce nectar. So in that case, plants, they have to do efforts to produce such kind of flowers. So in that case, it is not economical. Sometimes cross pollination may lead to the poor quality seed. Why does it happen? As I said you in the advantages that the good viable and healthier seeds are produced, but it happens sometimes that it may lead to produce the poor quality seed. So because what happens, there may be the mixing of some feeble genotype. Feeble means the weak one. Suppose the weak genes, if one or both the parent plant they have, and this genes when they mix, they come together after fertilization, in that case the seed will be produced, they will have the poor quality. So there are chances that this cross pollination may lead to produce the poor quality seed. So understood children, self pollination, cross pollination and their advantages and disadvantages. Now we have to study the difference between the self pollination and cross pollination. What is the difference between self pollination and cross pollination? We have studied in the detail, so you can understood it well. That self pollination occurs within same flower or between two flowers of the same plant. We have studied this is the autogamy, the first case, and the second case is the gynotogamy. But the cross pollination occurs in the two flowers of the two different plants, that we call it as a allogamy. Here no external agent required, but in cross pollination external agent is must, like wind, water, insects, birds, they are required. In self pollinations flowers are not attractive. Usually they are not attractive because as such there is no need to be showy. But in the cross pollination flowers are attractive with the colored petals. Why? In order to attract the pollinating agents. So in the self-pollination, small number of pollen grains are produced. So we can understand a small number of that pollen, they are sufficient in order to pollinate. But in the cross-pollination, large number of pollen grains are produced. Why the large number of pollen grains are produced? Because the pollen grains, they are carried by the external agents. In that case, there are chances of being wasted. So in that case, large number of pollen grains are produced. In self-pollination, flowers without scented petals or nectar, because there is no need. But in the cross-pollination, flowers with the scented petals and the nectar, that is needed in order to attract the insects or the pollinating agents. In this self-pollination, purity of race maintained. No variation occurs. Yes, purity of race maintained means what happens here? That offsprings which are produced by the self-pollination, they are similar to the parents, identical to the parents. No variation are produced or no variation occurs. Why it is so? Because the gametes which are produced on the same flower, they have the same genetic constitution. So after their fertilization, that identical seed is produced. Means seed is produced with the identical characters with the parents. Now in this case, cross-pollination, variation occurs. Why variation occurs? Because gametes which are produced in the two flowers, they belong to two different plants with the different genetic makeup or the genetic constitution. So this is the difference. So understood children? So these are the differences between the self-pollination and the cross-pollination. So today we have studied the pollination and the different types of pollination. In this self and cross, they are the two main types. Some other technical terms, autogamy, gynotogamy, allogamy, they also we have discussed. So you learn these terms also, because it can be asked in any of the way. Now next part we are going to discuss tomorrow, and you revise the chapter from the book also.